Hi and welcome back to Quinoa Pot Creations tutorial videos. Today I'm going to show how to make a small medicine bag pouch. The pouch I have here is about 2 by 3 inches and I'm just making some dot marks to give me some guidelines of making a small starburst design. So just finding the center and I'm putting some dots so I know where I want the design to go. So we're going to do a one needle method and we'll start right in the center where we made the dot for the center of the design. Just start with one bead in the center, and that is where we will work out from there outward. And just going to go right up next to that bead and start our first row to go straight up. So single needle method. We'll put 4 beads on and we're down right at the end of our 4 beads and come up through the middle 2 beads and go back through that 2 beads. Firm, tight, and 4 more beads. This box is a starburst designer, 8 beads long, so I'll go back up through in the middle of those 4 beads, and then we're going. Then I'm going to go back down through the whole line. Helps the line to lay flatter and kind of stabilizes the row and gets me back down to the center so that I can start the next line of the design in the other direction with the same procedure of 4 beads at a time. And with the dots that I drew, kind of shows me the straight line that I want it to go in. And I don't have lines drawn on the leather that you could see later. And come back up through that between the beads and go all the way back through the row that gets you down to the center of the design. And then we'll do the next rows to go in the opposite direction. Just kind of the first lines of the starburst design. And then go back up in through 2 beads. And then after the 4 main lines of the design, then you're going to put the other 4 lines in between and that will create the starburst . It's a real basic simple design that doesn't require any backing or drawing or anything, just real simple. I have a single thread, I didn't double the thread. It's just a single thread, works well. And back up through, back down through that whole row, gets you down to the center of the design, and you can just tie that off, and your design is all done, real quick and easy. Then you're going to fold the top down. I made some marks on it prior. But you're going to put four sets of two slits, which you will put the drawstring through later. But you don't want to cut the holes later. You want to do it before you assemble it. And so that it, the drawstring will go on there. You want a string on there and some fringe. The fringe you want to put on there needs to be put on before you sew it all together, so they're in the seam. Little rosette design on this bag. Real simple. The fringe will be placed between the layers, and you'll have one strip that goes all the way around, and then all those layers are sewed together. But before you do that, you want to kind of baste stitch the fringes to the bag so they're in place and they'll stay where you want them to be while you're sewing. So just a little baste stitch to tack it down in place. You sew them all, tack them all down where you want them to be. That way they'll stay in place while you're doing the sewing. And then once you do that, you're going to put the strip all the way around and just start to sew from the bottom around each side. And it's about a quarter of an inch wide strip that I cut. You find the center and put it right in the middle, and then the other side of the bag will go on top, and then you'll sew all those layers together, holding them all in place, and that fringe stays in place. You don't have to worry about holding it, and you're just going to go through all those layers, and kind of use a blanket stitch. You're going to go through basically like a whip stitch, but when you pull it all the way through, you're going to go through that loop, and it anchors the thread on the top of the seam that you're sewing, and it sits on top and it holds all those layers together better. Gives a better stitch, I think. So just go through all those layers and go back to the loop. Make shit sits on top of the seam of the bag. Give it a good firm pull and make sure it's tight. Pulls it all together nice. Go through the loop. Make sure the stitch sits on top. Nice even stitches. Give it a good seam. And you can see where the stitches are sitting on top and holding it all together. And you sew all the way around down one side and then down the other with that same stitch. And then you'll trim off the ends of the leather that's sticking out. Of the strip that you sewed into the seam. Then you'll turn the bag right side out. And the strip and the fringe are sewed into the seam nicely. Fringe is already attached and just kind of flatten out the seam. And then I use pinking shears and cut the strip all the way around, close to the bag as I can get, making sure that when I pull my pinking shears back up and set them back down there in the same groove, so it's a continuous cut. That makes it look much nicer than if you just cut a straight line and you cut it all the way around. And then that is it. Nice with the pinking shears. The fringe is attached better. And then you'll start in the middle of your four sets of two slits that you cut. And then you'll weave your string in and out all the way around. And a drawstring to close the bag. And you get back to the center in the front. You can pull that drawstring and tie the bow in the front of the bag. And then you can trim off the string to the length you want it. Makes you get a better idea of where you want it. And then there's your bags, all done. Well, thanks for stopping by. I hope you enjoyed this video tutorial. Make sure you like, share, and subscribe. You could always stop by and join our group, Creation Corner Beading Circle on Facebook, or you can visit my website, www.quinmapawcreations.com. Thanks for stopping by. See you next time.